for what I about to talk about, plenty people will not understand, and plenty people will understand what I'm about to say. If you're from this era gaming or this start gaming for you, you will fully understand this video. If not, then you could like just enjoy what I'm about to do. In case all you don't know, over the past few years, gaming become big in Trinidad. And I mean like down to people playing the most random games, people not even playing Warzone. Like a year or 2 years ago, people would only be streaming like Warzone because it's popular, or Fortnite because it's popular. No, they stream all different kinds of games, games that don't get recognized, games that don't get views anymore, like Outlast or DayZ, something like that. But what makes gaming special in this country? Yeah, people would have like Xbox 360 or like old PS3, PS2, PS1. But if it wasn't privileged and it was like me, you would have something called a fun station, and that is all that you would really have, that even gaming related, until the first edition Kamla laptops come out. I'm not talking about that scrawny little laptop they give out in the last few giveaways, and I'm talking about the big bulky black laptop with the bigger sticker that in a year or two it would actually like start overheating and shutting off by itself. But anyways, I'm pretty sure that start a whole bunch of people gaming careers. So if it was like an FPS gamer, you was probably playing things like COD 4 or like World of War or something.
What the hell kind of name is Soap, eh?
Or maybe it was like an alien FPS gamer and you only like games like Halo Combat Evolved or Area 51. Maybe it was that person who didn't like to share games like Crysis whenever the friend asks, Johnny? Or maybe it was like that person who loved horror games, which I did. One of the best games I ever played was Resident Evil 4. Teachers didn't give a shit. I just sat in front of the office playing Resident Evil 4. That was it. Maybe it's that one person who's gonna bring a game in school and it blew up in the school. Yeah, I bring Five Nights at Freddy's 1. An hour after it come out, I cracked that game and I bring that to the school. After I bring that, I was the only one who do it. I bring that game, the entire school start playing it, dude. So the point of this video is like, it wasn't like certain things that help start a gaming career. It was this specific thing probably for you. If I did not discover the camera laptop, could I play games? Which obviously like I didn't know about. I didn't know about games before that. I would have never have like an enthusiasm for gaming. I would have never find a hobby in gaming. I would have never be able to make videos that like I'm making today, which again, this have real skill going into that editing. Me editing, all that stem from the camera laptop. They talk about another game that was popular in school, but I didn't get to play it. Yeah, I never touched Minecraft in school, even though it was real popular. But the main reason I didn't touch it because nobody would show me how to download it. And all the fuckers was just like, oh my god, we're building a house together. Just like right as I was saying, like I could get the game. But I didn't start playing Minecraft until like 1.11.2. That was the latest I started playing. Getting that laptop in your hand was like Christmas. The biggest point in this video is that one laptop, that one, I go say, $1,000 laptop, start gaming that spanning over years. You want to know the weird thing about this too that you could probably relate to if you had this experience? This experience bring a whole bunch of people together. Didn't matter which class you was in, didn't matter what was your popularity status in school. You could be the nerdiest, shyest person in the school, or the most popular, noisy person in the school, and when lunchtime come, all they're playing Halo together. That was basically what was going on in them times. But anyways, the thing to take away from this video is that that experience legit changed people's lives for the future. It creates hobbies and skills in people that they probably didn't even know they had. But anyways, that is really it for this video. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have some nostalgia from this video, then the video work. If you just like understand where we was coming from, if you didn't experience this but you understand it and you actually had fun watching the video, just drop a like, and that is really it. See you later in the Dying Light 2 review.